Very warm good evening to all. Article 226 of the Indian Constitution has got a very good scope, and those as a lawyer who are practicing in the High Court, they know that like we call in Supreme Court writs in and out of the Article 136, same way the High Court has got a very wide scope, and it covers in its ambit lot of things. So Article 226 is very wide, and normally many writ petitions are filed in the same, and it has changed the lot of scenario also at a state level. But whenever you draft a writ petition and files under Article 226, you always mention one averment. That averment is called, it says like this, that there is no alternate remedy or efficacious remedy available to the petitioner, and that is the reason this is the only remedy and he is before this honorable court. So when you write this averment, always remember that you are making an on oath, you are telling the court that I have only this remedy, no alternate remedy, that's why I am before this court. Any statute, whatever orders you are challenging, or whatever proceeding you are challenging, you are trying to tell the court, that is the High Court, Honorable High Court, that I have no other efficacious remedy. Efficacious, the meaning of the efficacious is effective. So you, if you don't have an effective remedy, so naturally the ambit of the Article 226 is very wide, and you try to seek justice from the High Court. Now, High Court do entertain the under the all the petition under Article 226, but it has got restriction. It has put restriction. It has not got, but it has put restriction where it will sometime it will not entertain Article 226 petitions under Article 226. Now in today's lecture, as we progress, I would like to discuss some of the judgments where it has been allowed, even though alternate remedy was available. And when it was available, then why in those cases, why this in those cases Article 226 writ petitions were allowed and they were given the reliefs. Now here, first we will take Article 226. What is it? See, Article 226 is for enforcement of fundamental rights, or for any other purpose. Now, any other purpose means all the legal rights can be exercised through it. So whenever if any legal right is also taken away from you, you have every right to approach the Honorable High Court under Article 226. Now here, there are cases where fundamental rights are breached, or there are some reason, you know all that there are five writs also, habeas corpus, quo warranto, probation, certiorari, mandamus. These writs are also allowed. But apart from that, for any other legal purpose also Article 226 is utilized. Now, whenever you go to court and when you write this averment, you have to satisfy the Honorable High Court, the judges, that there is no alternate remedy. And even if it is available, there is a reason why the Honorable High Court should entertain my petition under Article 226. Recently, a judgment which is delivered by the Supreme Court, Justice Chandrachud, the judgment is Messrs. Radhakrishnan Industries Limited versus State of Himachal Pradesh. This is of recent 2021. Now, this was a GST matter. And naturally, it's a tax matter. So there was a commissioner of the joint commissioner of the Himachal sales tax and excise who passed an order under Section 83 of the Local Act. And under this, there was again a remedy available to the petitioners, the company, Messrs. Radhakrishnan, to appeal against that order. Now, if they have an appeal, they cannot approach the Honorable High Court. Still, they approach the Honorable High Court of the Himachal Pradesh, where they say the Section 83, whatever the order was passed under Section 83, was without jurisdiction and it was without the application of mine. And the because the bread and butter of the company has been snatched, there was some attachment also, provisional attachment. And that's why the company was unable to operate their bank accounts. Now here the see the rights is infringed of the petitioner. Now when they approach the Himachal Pradesh High Court, what happened? The article under Article 226, their petition was not allowed. Now this order was carried to the Supreme Court. Supreme Court said though there is an alternate remedy available to the petitioner, still under Article 226, their petition is maintainable. And Supreme Court allowed under the Article 226 their petition. And the order under Section 83, which was passed by the Himachal Pradesh GST Tax Local Act, it was set aside. The reason was that it was without application of mind. So in this judgment, if you go through that, there are some principles summarized. The 3-4 principles which I would like to tell you basically, that whenever fundamental rights are infringed or violated, or you require to enforce fundamental rights, then you could approach under Article 226, though you have an alternate remedy. Number two, well, rule of natural justice are violated, they are not followed. Then also you can approach the court, Honorable High Court under 226. There may be an act which is passed by the state legislature or the parliament at a central level. Then also if the act is ultra vires, then also you have a right to approach the High Court under Article 226. And if it is a central level, you can go at the under Article 32. Now, there may be an order or proceeding which is you feel totally vitiated, wrongly passed, then also you can approach the Honorable High Court of the state level. Now, here all these four, these are exceptions to fundamental rights, natural justice, rule of natural justice. If it is ultra vires of any legislature, then any order or proceeding which is totally beyond jurisdiction passed by maybe a magistrate or a trial court judge, that can also be entertained under the writ jurisdiction of the Honorable High Court. So complete what I want to say here, that whenever, even if you have an alternate remedy under Article 226, your petition can be entertained. If you are able to show to the court that these are the reasons, these are the exception which covers. So Mrs. Radha Krishnan's versus Industry versus State of Himachal Pradesh is the landmark judgment of 2021. And it's a very recent judgment. If you read all the principles summarized therein, and you will have a complete idea that when you can file a petition under Article 226. Because, see, filing a petition is very easy, but to get it admitted and get an order from the High Court is really difficult if you are unable to convince, especially when you have an alternate remedy. So, title of the today's lecture, that 227 alternate remedy, the reason behind that is this. Now I will take a very simple example to make you all understand that we all know of domestic violence cases. Now domestic violence cases are filed either in the judicial magistrate first class or magistrate court in the metropolitan cities. So whenever we file these petitions before the metropolitan magistrate, the respondents go directly to the High Court and they challenge it under Article 226. If you are what a respondent, if you are vigilant, you know that in the Domestic Violence Act, there is a Section 29, which provides appeal from any of the order passed in Domestic Violence Act by the magistrate court, which lies to the session court or the senior division in a village remote area. Now, if you know Section 29, then there is an alternate remedy available. Then there is a remote chance that High Court will entertain any petition of the domestic violence, for quashing the domestic violence petition filed by the wife or any aggrieved lady, and which is carried to the High Court by the respondent. So you can always say they have a remedy under Section 29 of the Domestic Violence Act. So first we have to exhaust that remedy. Then only we can approach the Honorable High Court, which will be in revisional jurisdiction and not under Article 226. That is another chapter which we can cover later. But here when we file under Domestic Violence Act, The appeal will lie under the section 29. I mean to say there is an altered remedy available to the parties. Still they are approaching the High Court. So the meaning of the all this is that if there is alternate remedy and still you are approaching the High Court, unless and until your petition comes under these 3-4 exceptions, it will not be entertained. And if the respondent against whom the petition is entertained is vigilant enough to show these reasons, then it will naturally be not entertained. So it will be futile exercise to approach directly the Honorable High Court. So Radhakrishnan case, where though there was alternate remedy, it was allowed, but because it was there was some exception to the same. Now another case I would like to take here is authorized officer of State Bank of Travancore versus Matthew Casey. Now this is also very recent judgment. As the name suggests, it's a bank matter. This person Matthew has taken a loan and he was unable to pay the same. So naturally, the bank, after waiting for some time, they approached the legal forum and passed the act, an order under Section 13 of SARFAESI Act. Now, when they passed an order under Section 13 of SARFAESI Act, though he had a remedy in DRT, where he could go, that is debt recovery tribunal, and he could have taken out his proceedings, he approached the Honorable High Court directly under Section 220, Article 226, for assailing this order. Now, when this came before the court, though the High Court allowed it, but the matter was taken to the Supreme Court. Supreme Court said, it's a public money, first of all. Number two, he has not paid the loan amount and he had it is not something of a matter which is of public importance. And it was not falling in any of the exceptions, which the Supreme Court has laid down all the ratios, where it was not falling in any of the exceptions. Whatever judgment till 2018, which came for 226 and an alternate remedy. So the Supreme Court said that this cannot be entered in under Article 226. And naturally, the petition of the Article 226, which was carried to the Supreme Court, the order was set aside. And he has no other approach except that he has to apply to DRT. So under SARFAESI Act also, it's your personal matter. Article 226, only when your fundamental rights are you have to enforce the fundamental rights, they are encroached or violated, or rule of natural justice are not followed, or any act which is ultra vires, or any order proceeding as beyond jurisdiction passed by the lower courts. Now, this is one case where Article 226, though order was passed by the High Court, the Supreme Court set it aside. Now, we have one more case where 226 was allowed of a Patna High Court. BJCL Srinath versus State of Bihar. Now here it was a contractual obligation. This person has filled a tender and he was awarded the contract. He signed the contract, but he was not able to fulfill some of the conditions. So the department, which was municipal department, it rescinded the contract. It issued a notice to him. When he issued a notice to him, there was no grounds given properly and he was not even heard. And when his contract was repudiated without asking him, the Patna High Court said that when it heard his matter under Article 226, that natural justice is not, rule of natural justice is not followed. See, when the rule of natural justice is not, though it's a contractual obligation, it's not something which is of the matter of public importance here. Still, the Patna High Court heard the matter, and under 226, the order passed by the department was set aside, and it was set back that it has to be reconsidered. So now here it's a totally contractual obligation. It was totally commercial matter. Still, the court entertained under Article 220. The reason behind that, rule of natural justice was not followed. There was no grounds was given. There was no application of mind while passing an order by the department, which tender, which issued the tenders, and he has been selected. So this is also contractual obligation matter also, Article 226 petition was entertained. So this was very surprising, but if you go to the root of the matter, you will understand why it was allowed. So it is not that even if you have an alternate remedy under Article 226, your petition will not be allowed. Now we have another interesting matter of the Supreme Court. Very short, but I would say very important matter. It's a very short order. Nilam Manmohan Attawar versus Manmohan Attawar. Now here this Manmohan Attawar, when the proceedings were on, he was no more and he was represented by the legal heirs. Now it's a DV matter, very interesting matter. This girl Neelam lady, she has filed a domestic violence petition before the trial court, and both the trial court dismissed. First she filed before the magistrate court, she did not get any order. Then it was taken to the under section 29, appeal was carried, where also it did not stand because she was not married, though she was in domestic relationship. After the session court's order under section 29 appeal, when it was dismissed, the matter was carried to the High Court. Now, when the matter was carried to the High Court also did not find any substance in the matter and it dismissed. Now, after DV matter was dismissed under section 29, she has filed under revisional jurisdiction of the High Court, DV matter in appeal. Now, when she filed in revision matter, it was dismissed. She carried the same matter of the single bench of the High Court to the double DV matter, that is double bench under Article 226. Now, High Court said under Article 226, this matter cannot be entertained because the Honorable High Court single bench judge has already passed an order. So, this matter was transferred to the Supreme Court. Now, when this matter came before Supreme Court, the Supreme Court, it was like a transfer petition. Now, when this matter came before Supreme Court, the Supreme Court said that it is a single bench judgment and this you have only one remedy, that when High Court passes an order, it can be challenged before the Supreme Court under Article 136. But this lady chose to file under Article 226. She was given amicus curiae because she was appearing in person. She was not aware about all this. Technical terms and the legal provisions. So she refused, though then an order was passed that this matter is sent back to the High Court, or she can go, sorry, she, this matter was not sent back to the High Court. Under Article 136, she has a remedy, but this matter again under Article 226, she cannot approach the High Court. Because once the High Court single bench judgment passed an order under revisional jurisdiction, the same has only one remedy, that is she can approach the Honorable Supreme Court under Article 136. So this is though very short matter, but the way it is carried and the way it is discussed, I would like all of you to read this. But this is one matter where I found a DV matter has so many, I would say, layers to it, and very beautifully written judgment. So you all must go through this, and once you go through this, you know that how DV matters can also be have so many dimensions, and it can be taken to the Supreme Court, but under Article 136 and not even under 226, it cannot be carried to the High Court. So this was all about